OP Mamba. So today I'm going to be doing top 10 characters I want in OPBR. So this is basically like my top 10 characters I want to see in OPBR, like in the future. On here, I did not include like the leaks that we already had, like for example, Blackbeard, Yamato, Marco, Young Rayleigh. Like I did not include the leaks. I just want like new characters, you know? Alright, so let's get started, alright? So number one, I have Shinki the Gold Lion as a red runner. Alright, so this man Shinki, I really do like him, bro. Like in the movie, bro, I don't know if they fucking nerfed him or something, but like he was, I think he got nerfed. But yeah, he's gonna be a red runner. The sword will be used in his normal likes. So you see the sword, right? He will be using that in his normals. So skill one combines his sword skill with his Fuwa Fuwa no Mi. That's his double fruit, such as slashing open a body of water and then levitating it to drown his opponent. So Fuwa Fuwa no Mi, his double fruit, whatever, like it makes you float. Like whenever he touches something, it makes it float and shit like that. So, and he can also open body of water. Like bruh, tell me that shit don't sound OP. So skill two, Shinki uses the surrounding environment against his enemies, shaping earth or snow into giant lion heads and launching them towards his foes, or even making wet water float to drown his opponent in it. So basically skill two, like bunch of shit's gonna come out, like say like a giant lion head. It has like in snow and all that shit, it's all mixed and it's a huge fucking skill, basically skill two. And in the last like ending, it has like water that makes you drown. Like imagine that shit in OPBR, bruh. Imagine, like that shit would be so cool. So yeah, that's my number one, Shinki the Gold Lion, a red runner. So number two, I have King as a blue runner. All right King will transform into his hybrid mode, you know, when he goes into his dragon form, you know, it becomes more cooler. All right on the last hit of normal, it will include King Large Katana, aka his sword. All right from his right hip, you see the sword right here, let me show you. This sword right here, he will be using that on his last normal string. All right so skill one, while being on his normal state, does a huge slash using his katana, includes burn 25%. So I included burn because I remember like he has little fire shit back in his back. Like yeah, that's, I thought it was gonna be a cool little concept thingy. So skill two goes into his hybrid form, does a forward attack just like Pell, but it's gonna have more range into it, like more range, and also inflicts burn 100%. Like that shit's burning your ass basically. So yeah, King, I really do like King over Queen and Jack. Like I don't care what anybody says, King is cool, bro. Like you know, like especially his hybrid form, also I fuck with a heavy. So he's gonna be a blue runner. All right so number three, version 2 Kizaru red attacker. This version 2 Kizaru will be with the sword. I seen one concept, like it was on Twitter by a random guy, a random Japanese or Chinese guy, I don't know, but it looked really cool. This is where I got the idea from, and it's about time we get a new Kizaru also. So normal speed up as you keep hitting the enemy, so like as you keep hitting the enemy, your normal is gonna move quicker. Like that would be so cool, bruh. Skill one, Amaterasu bursting your points, his index and his middle finger into the air or at his enemy in form of a peace sign, and emits a powerful flash of light, confusing his opponent. And skill 2 uses this meaning sword of gathering clouds of heaven, does a huge sword slash, and on the last string has an explosion. So you can like basically combo skill 1 and skill 2. That's what I made it. Like you can use skill 1, confuse the enemy, use skill 2 directly. It's fucking OP basically. Like for him as a character, I wanted to make him fast as shit. Like his normal fast as hell, skill fast as hell. Like that's what I was going for. And he's gonna be a red attacker because we already have a runner, and defender will just be lame as fuck in my opinion. So for number 4, I have Diamond Zozu Green Defender. Bro, I love this man. I don't know why. Like, I fuck with Diamond Zozu heavy. Alright, so Zozu will be on his diamond form at all times. So this, none of this bullshit, only for like certain period of times. No, he will be on his diamond state all the time. Alright. Skill 1. A counter when you get hit by the enemy, you knock them back and heal, and skill 2 cooldown by 30%. So he will have a counter. Like when you get hit by the enemy, you will knock them back and get HP recovery and skill 2 by 30%. Skill 2, Brilliant Punk. Basically a powerful tackle, Zozu rushes toward an enemy at high speed and slams the person with his diamond transform forearm, dealing damage and launching the target a fair distance back and recover HP up 25%. So his thing is like knockback and recovering HP. So he's basically just a tanky defender that recovers HP when doing a knockback shit. But yeah, Zozu, like, I've been wanting him in OPBR. Like, I've been waiting for a minute, man. Like, I really do want Zozu. Hopefully one day. So for number 5, yes, Big Buddha. Young Buddha, aka Sengoku. I really like the Buddha, bro. No cap. I don't know what it is. Like, I might be a Marine simp. Like, I do like a lot of Marine characters. And I went attacking character type captain enemy. Hold on, let me read that shit back. When attacking character type captain enemy, increased damage dealt by 45%. So that's the same trait as Garp. Like, I did want to have that trait on him because, you know, Garp and Sengoku kind of duo shit. So skill 1 puts the character into a giant Buddha state and an attack is increased with a high critical hit chance. State is gone when enough damage is taken a set period of time, cooldown to 51 seconds. So that one's basically like I stole some idea from Zoro's the hockey state thingy. So I put the crit and all that shit a little bit over there, you know. But yeah, he's gonna, like, skill 1, he's just basically gonna go into a giant Buddha. So skill 2 sends out giant shockwave that has long range multiple hit area with a high chance to inflict stun. When stun is completed, recover HP by 10%. So skill 2, you know, he's known for his shock thingy. Like, so this one's gonna be a long range, and I know for sure the old Sengoku, that one's a medium, that's a mid-range thing, mid-range shock. So this one's gonna be a long range multiple hit area, so that shit's gonna be broken, no cap. So, and when he also does stun, so when he does stun, recover HP up at 10%, and he's a green attacker. You know, I did want to show like every color some love, like not only red and blue, as you know, people still hate on green, but you know, it is what it is. So I'm pretty sure I'll make this a part 1, and I'll be recording part 2 tomorrow. So, you know, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and I guess wait for part 2. That's it. See you on part 2. Peace out.